do you want to embed the PDF viewer in your website, but you don't want people to download that PDF? In this video, I'm going to explain to you three options on how to embed the PDF viewer in your website without the ability to download. Let's get started. Option one is the HTML embed tag. Probably most of you know this tag. This allows you to easily embed the PDF document into your website. I added the document to the directory files, and it's the Bitcoin white paper. I'm choosing a height, I'm choosing 500 in this case, and I'm choosing a width of 1000. And let's save and see. Okay, now we're getting here the PDF document, but what you will see is still the print, the download button, and that's what we don't want. So what we can do here is we can add toolbar equals zero. Now, if we refresh, then you will see that the toolbar is gone. So also the download button is gone. I want you guys to know that this document is not really not downloadable, because you can still easily download it by looking into the source code. Because if I'm looking here in inspect element and I'm going to the embed tag, open it in a new tab, you will see that easily I can remove your toolbar, click download, and it will open the download button. You will still be able to download. So this is not really what we want. So I want to show you a couple of other options that are possible. Okay, the next option I want to talk about is Google Drive. You all know Google Drive, and you can upload a PDF document to Google Drive, and by right clicking on the document and clicking share, you'll have the option here in the settings to disable the download, print, and copy option. So I'm unchecking this box. I make sure that this one is set on anyone with the link is allowed to view it. Then I'm copying the link, going back to my website, and I'm creating an iframe. With the source, the link that we just got, we do the width 1000 and we do a height of 500. We refresh the page and we see a forbidden error. That is because we have to change this last part of the URL to preview. Now we refresh the page and what we see is the document. Okay, the document is now embedded into the website and you're not able to download it. In this case, also in the source code, you are unable to find the PDF document. So this is a much more secure version. What I don't like about this version is that it's not so customizable. So you can't really customize the viewer. You also don't get analytics. So I have a third option that includes analytics and customizable viewer. The last option I want to talk about, that's Cloud PDF. On Cloud PDF, you can make an account and you can upload your document. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to log in as my account. Okay, so I upload the Bitcoin white paper. So I drop the Bitcoin white paper here. I click upload selected files. Now it's uploading the Bitcoin white paper. Okay, now I click on the document, click on embed. And then here you have a little snippet that you can include into your website. You have to change the permissions. So we have to change the permission to publicly accessible. Then I have a couple of other settings that I could set. The allow downloading we don't want. I click submit. Then I'm copying this snippet in the website. Then I save it and I refresh. And here's the viewer. So what I really like about this viewer is that you can set a theme color. So you can make the whole viewer different colors and make it suit your website. So what I can do here is I can say app bar colored to, then theme color, and then any hex. If I want to do a red color and I refresh, what you will see now is that the viewer has like a red toolbar and the theme is red. So you can choose whatever website colors you have, your own like branding color. Then you have dark mode, which you can set to false, and now it's non-dark mode. And if you set it to true, it's dark mode. Another option that I really like about this viewer is that it registers a visitor. So if I'm now scrolling to a different page, to this page, for example, I'm staying here for a bit, then I scroll to the next page and I stay there for a bit. Okay. Now I refresh the page, then it registers that session. Then I go to analytics and then it will show me the last visitor from New York, United States, the first page, the second page, and the third page. And it stayed 2 seconds on the third page, 6 seconds on the second page, and 11 seconds on the third page. So you get more insight in how people are looking in your document, what pages they visit. I think that's quite cool. If you want to make this responsive, you can make this 100%. And now it's responsive, so it will also working well on mobile. Okay, I hope you guys liked this video and that it was useful for you. If you like this video, please leave a like and leave a comment on the video if you want to see more of these kind of videos. Thank you so much and see you in the next video.